Hi everybody, Ollie here, aka Secret Nimbus here, another episode of Test Pack Please Ignore 2. So at the end of my last episode, I had been doing a little bit of bee breeding, but before I get back to that, what I want to make at the beginning of this episode is a mining laser. Now, I suddenly remembered that I actually fancied making one of these, so I think we're going to crack on and try and make one. Now, do we have anything already in place for this? No. Do I ever have that iron turning blank drill? I don't think I need the drill one, do I? No, I need handle one. So I have to make one of them in a second. So let's make some energerium dust first, in which case we'll need some diamonds. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We need to run that through macerator, maybe, I think will work. Yeah, the macerator will work there. Excellent. So we'll get that going in a second. We also need some advanced alloys. So can I make that? I think this is the only way to make it on this particular version of the pack. So I'm going to need, what was it? Bronze plates. So do I have any bronze or tinkers? There you go, tinkers alloy ingots. Actually, I'm going to need more of that. So let me get some copper. 1, 2, 3, and tin. Also a hopper. Although, where is my hopper at the moment? Where have I left it? Ah, it's over there at the moment. Let me go and find that. Oops, Daisy. What am I doing? I want you. Let me get my pickaxe so I don't accidentally break everything in the general vicinity. I want to go to the hub. And then I want my... where is it? Induction smelter. That's what I need. I'm going to make up a load of Tinker's Alloy ingots. So let me... start making you like so. So we're going to drop in some tin, some copper, and then a load of copper in here. So that should make up quite a few stacks of Tinker's Alloy ingots. Perfect. Because I'm going to need more of it in a minute for what I want to do for the rest of the episode. But we need the plate bending machine or the metal former. There we go. We'll send you to rolling. We need 3 plates. There we go. So we've got a diamond dust, which is good. So what we can now do is drop you in there, make up that energerium dust. There we go. Compress you down in the compressor. Marvellous. So that should take a few seconds. So we've almost got the 3 bronze plates that we need. We need to get started on the electric... we need to do the turning table, don't we? So got to remember how to do that. So need an iron turning... What do I need for that again? I can't remember. Trying to remember how I did that now. So I've got the lathing tool. And then I need the iron turning blank. Let me have a quick look at this. So was it just iron? Oh, was it like an iron block or something like that? Let me grab some iron. I think it might be an iron block. I can't remember. Block of iron? No, what was it again? I can't remember how this thing works. Ha, that's interesting. I will be right back. I'm just going to go remember how to actually use this turning table, I think it is. Yeah, turning table. So I'll be back in a sec, guys. Okay, guys, so I'm back. And it turns out that I was derping out. I need to actually make one of these iron turning blanks first. So let me go and drop this into here. Then what we need to do is let's go back to the mining laser. Here we go. So I need to make, so it's 4, 5, 3, 5, 2, 5, 2, 5, 2, 5. So if we do 4, 5, 3, 5, 2, 5, 2, 5, and 2, 5. There we go. So that should be, yeah, there we go. Iron turning blank handle. Perfect. Right. So that's all sorted. I have that bronze plate. So we now need to make the mixed metal. So that made 2. Ah, right. Hang on. I need more, don't I? So let me get some. Some more tinkers out. Oh, no, I've still got it on my person. Whoops-a-daisy. So we need to go 1, 2, 3 again. Start turning you. That's the MFE. That's not what I want. I want that energy crystal out of there and the mixed metal ingots to go in there. I was wondering if I have any of the... What's it called? Advanced alloy. No, I do not. So just thought I'd double check before having to make up some more. There's 2, we just need a 3rd one, so there's one of the advanced alloys. Let's go grab the rest of this in a second, come on. There we go. So we can now make another lot of mixed metal. Let's drop you back in there. Yeah, with when Greg Tex finally added, we're down one iron plate. Damn it. Can I make one real quick? There we go. Spot on. So let's make you. We shall then go into the back to the compressor. Drop you in. So he's going to wait for that to compress. Was there anything else we needed? Just redstone, advanced alloys. Ah, yes, an advanced circuit. Let's make that real quick while we are at it. So can I make this an ordinary one? Nope. What am I missing? Ah, I'm probably missing an iron plate, aren't I? Yep, one iron plate. Oopsie-daisy. I want the IC2 version, please. There we go. I'm just doing it with the forge hammer just because I am trying to save a bit of time. So then we should be able to make the advanced one now, in theory. There we go, one advanced. What's the word I'm looking for? Yeah, my brain's gone. One advanced circuit, that's what I'm looking for. So why are you not doing that? Let's go for the advanced alloy. So 1, 2, 3. We need the crystal, which I've got on my person. Whoops-a-daisy. We need redstone. Like that. We need a circuit. I think it's because I didn't have everything in the system, so it's kind of having a little mini freak out. And there we go, we've made ourselves a mining laser. Very nice. So let me just drop that in the MFE, like so. So that's going to charge up. So the reason I wanted to make one of these is actually you can use it to harvest like hives without having to use a scoop. So let me go to here because I need to sleep for the night. I'll try out in a second just to confirm that. So you used to be able to shoot hives with it, and it basically just acted as a bit like a scoop in that regard. So let me grab you, like so. So we've got the mining lasers, we can go pew pew pew. So I'm not sure what mode it's on right now. Let me just double check my controls, see what the I'm looking for. I'm looking for IC2. So mode switch key is minus at the moment, so do I need to be firing? That seems to be alright. So, is it pewing? Yeah, there we go. So, it's actually pewing now. Oops, I've set the tree on fire. Oh dear, come on, put it out. There we go. Much better. So, what I'm looking for is, I know there's a hive around here somewhere. Just remember whereabouts it is. I think you can see. Ah, there it is. Can I shoot that? There we go. Look at that. Look. It actually releases the drones from the hive without you actually having to use a scoop. I would still very much like to... Let me go back and have a quick check of the controls. So, mode switch key is definitely minus. Oh, I can hear a creeper. Crap, that was close. Whoops-a-daisy. Where the hell did he come from? That was actually terrifying. The hell is that? Oh, a sacred oak sapling. I do not want you going down. I'm fairly sure if that grows at all, it basically produces some kind of like crazy huge tree or something like that. Let's kill some zombies with the mining laser. Ah, look at this. Beautiful. Could have done with this against the Ender Dragon, really. Maybe a bit of a mistake not to have done so. So yeah, I'm pressing minus, whichever... Oh no, I'm pressing the wrong one for... Is that minus? Ah, there we go. So I want low focus for the mining laser. So it should, in theory, only mine out one square at a time now, which is what I wanted it to do. Grand. Cool. So that is my mining laser constructed. So what I want to get on for the rest of the episode is starting to do a little bit more advanced bee stuff. So let me put some stuff away. I'm going to need that honeycomb. Let's pop over to the bees. Let me also then put these new hive bees into here, like so. What have we managed to breed up around here? Ooh, got some honeycombs, which is good. We get these two, this lot breeding again. So I'm going to need to make some more. See an apple. I'll be right back in a sec, guys. Just got to go do something for a second. Okay, guys, so I'm back. Sorry about that. Just had to pop away and do something for a second. So what do I want to do with the bees today? Now, I want to start diving into the genetics part of Binnie's kind of extra bees and stuff like that. Now, to kind of make the whole bee breeding process easier, I just want to have a quick look and see what these bees look like if we grab the bee-alyzer. So, I'm out of honeycombs, aren't I? Oh, wow, I only got one from that. That's kind of depressing. Honeycomb? That's forest cultivated. Now, let me drop you back in there. I want cultivated. Do I have a pure cult? Or do I have a forest cultivated? Cultivate common. There we go. Cultivated forest. That's what I want. So I'm hoping that... Or do I go for like cultivated? I think that might be better. So I'm hoping that the cultivated will only breed with other cultivated, if that makes sense. Now I'll just try forest cultivated again. Yeah, I basically need more honeycomb or honey. Let me have a quick look at honey drops. Is there any other way of getting it apart from... No, the only way to get it is literally just centrifuge out comb. So I need something which produces a lot more than what I've got. So these ones kind of produce them very occasionally, but not in any great quantity. So I need to just get a load of them from somewhere. I need to just have more and more bees just producing honeycombs for a while, I think. So I might need to build some more apiaries at some point. I've only got four right now, which is kind of depressing. Yeah, these frames are still working, which is good. Yeah, where was I? So in terms of making things a little bit easier, so if I were to say, for example, run out of a particular species, you can imprint them on like a kind of any drone, which is quite nice. So what I really want to do, if we go to back to genetics, I want to start working on some genetics machines. So in terms of making something like the incubator, I'm trying to remember why I need to do something first. So I think the incubator is the first machine I need to make, because from that, if I want to make something like the inoculator, you need not the integrated circuit board, is it sequencer, or do I want isolator? I think it's isolator. I need this enzyme, and the way you get the enzyme is from the incubator. So let's get started with this. So I'm going to head back over to my hub. Let's go grab some of that Tinker's alloy, wherever you are. You're in here, aren't you? There we go. Two stacks of it. Very nice. That'll do. Should do us nicely. So let me make the incubator. So this is also these are also going to be useful later on as well. So we need to make a sturdy casing, followed by a reinforced casing, which is a sturdy casing surrounded by iron. We need to make some of these enhanced circuits. So we need some tinkers. There we go. So we'll grab half a stack. We also need some water and some redstone. So there we go. So I've got a bucket on me, which is good. Let's go to Thorncraft so I can just grab some water there. Go there, drop it in the carpenter. So I don't want that recipe anymore. There we go. The recipe I do want, however, looks a lot like this. There we go. So we're going to need two of these. So let me just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. That should be fine. Just so I can control how many I've made. I don't want to make too many, put it that way. So basically what I'm doing with this is that the incubator is going to allow us to make this enzyme, and then the isolator should allow me to start picking out traits and making these serums. So I think I might also going to need a... I'm not sure what I need for these serums. I think I need an empty serum vial, which is gold and glass. So yeah, we also can make this growth medium, which is sugar and bone meal. I'm not sure what that's used for. This has been changed a bit since I last used kind of Binnie's versions of the mod. So I've got one circuit there, so we need some more water. So let me go to here, grab some more water, drop you in there. Is that going to be enough? Yep, that is enough to make the second enhanced circuit board. Probably going to need some kind of like power supply or something like that as well. But we're going to get the second advanced circuit board. Let's head back over here. Drop you in there. So in terms of the incubator, we need a furnace, which we can make. We should have glass panes already in there. We need a gear. And then that should be everything. And we've made ourselves an incubator. Very nice. So head back over here. Plonk it down. Come on. There we go. There. Marvellous. So this is the incubator. So... the incubator combines liquids and items and allows them to sit at an ideal temperature to encourage bacterial growth. Now, I am going to need some sugar. So I've got some sugar canes here, which we can turn into sugar like so. I think we're going to need some water. So let me go grab some more of that. Probably do with like creating an infinite water source over here as well. Can I drop water in there? There we go. So that fills that up. So it's 50% full. So I'm going to go grab another bucket of water while we're at it. Here we go. So I can drop you in there. Marvellous. Then we need some sugar, I think. So there is no valid recipe. So to activate help tooltips, hold down the tab key and mouse over controls. So what the hell are the valid recipes then? There's no valid recipe. I'm sure it's supposed to be sugar and water, unless I'm doing something wrong. Hang on, I'll be right back again, and I just need to figure out what I need to use instead of water, I think. So I'll be back in a sec. Okay, guys, so I'm back. So it turns out that the whole process here is actually like a three-stage process. So what we need to start off by doing is making some of this growth medium. So that just requires crafting together some sugar and some bone meal. Ah, hang on, I don't need as much as I thought. So what we need to do first is drop in this growth medium, which is going to incubate, and that's going to make growth medium like so. So I may need to make a couple more incubators. So let me pop over to the hub. Let me go back to the incubator. So we need some more of these enhanced circuit boards. So let me start crafting them first. So we need 12 of you. There we go. And we also need the water. So we might as well do this quick. So yeah, I'm going to need to... Let's make an infinite water source here. So that's completely the wrong area. We wanted Thorncraft there. There we go. Much better. I'm also going to need some planks. Or slabs even, sorry. There we go. Marvellous. So what I'm going to do is just... That should be fine. Perfect. So put one bucket there. One bucket. There we go. So two. That's not what I wanted. Three and four. There we go. So that should start making the enhanced circuit boards. Fantastic. That's what I like to see. So yeah, this has made some growth medium. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have like a series of incubators, I think. So have them running along. I don't know whether to just eliminate this hardened energy cell and just put conduit directly in here, which would probably be a better idea. I'm just going to move this bed as well. Let me do that quick. So Daisy, I'm trying to do. Here we go. So where do I want the bed? I actually have no idea where I can put this now. Put it down there for some random reason. How are we doing? So we've got all the circuit boards we need. So let's head back to the hub. Drop you in there. So we need two more sturdy casings. If it actually, you know, clicks more than once, would be nice. Two more of you, and then that should be everything. Note, we need some more glass panes. There we go. Ah, right. No, we need the bronze gears, don't we? Ah, that's not what I wanted. One, two. Perfect. Right, that should now be enough. So one, two more incubators. We also need some fluid conduits. And also just some enhanced energy conduits. So let me zip back over to here. What I'm going to do is grab my yeeter wrench. Wrench up you. Make sure this is on energy conduits like so. And then knock you into there. Wrench up some of these energy conduits here. And then just make this look a little bit neater, basically. There we go, it's a bit neater. I'll probably have to figure out some way of making this all look snazzy at some point, but not right now, not when I'm in the middle of something. So we've got these two incubators, so we need one and two, and then I do not want that connecting up. Marvellous. So then what we need to drop down is... Actually, I've just realised can't wrench that up, which is annoying. So what I'm going to do is I can actually have these running under each other. So because I can have... Oopsie-daisy. So that one, two, and three. So I can drop down my two incubators like... Ah, no. Just realized that... Right, let me go to fluid ones. I want to wrench you up. I thought I was going to be clever there and it didn't quite work as I intended. So I'm just going to go back around to all. There we go. So... Can I have them all next to each other? I don't know. Wrench you up and then let's grab the fluid conduits. So that one will go to there and then that one will go to there. Marvellous. So what I now need to do is have that go into extract even. There we go. Active with that signal. So that's going to pump into that one. Excellent. That's exactly what I want. And then that one would go to extract as well, but it won't extract anything because that's the extract, the extraction one. Right. So we're back on it now. Momentary lapse of judgment there. So we've got some growth medium going into there, which we then need to react with wheat, which should start creating something else. Not enough incubation liquid, right? So we need some more of that growth medium. So yeah, that should hopefully be enough. Let's react you up. So that's going to create more of that going into there. Hopefully we've made enough. So I'm assuming that's just going to start reacting. There we go. So that's going up, and then that's going to then react with the wheat, which is good. So that's making bacteria, which is going into here, which we then finally need to react with some sugar. And then that should, in theory, create the enzyme. Come on. We're going to do it. We're going to create enzyme. So it's basically just saying, I need more bacteria. So what are we missing? So we've still got growth medium going through, which is good. So yeah, not enough incubation liquid, basically. So it's just a kind of a... is that the same with all of it? Yeah, that's the same with all of it. So Daisy, don't want that one. So probably should have like a fluid, some kind of thing going in here just to keep supplying it with... So I can't actually put any more water in there at the moment because it's gone above 50%. But as soon as that drops below 50%, I will top it up. Has used up the last of the enzymes though, so how are we doing? Is that reacting? That is still reacting at the moment. Although we have run out of wheat. So apparently I've still not made enough. So I may need to make some kind of wheat farm, I think. So grab some seeds. Can I add it to this one, maybe? I don't know. Nah, I think I might have to do it myself. So if we head down to... Do I have a hoe on me? I think I can make one. Let's grab a hoe. Here we go, that'll do. So then we need to head down to... Nah, if I really should just head to a village or something like that and do it, but I think I should probably make it myself. So Daisy, don't want to go there. I wanted to head down this way. There we go. As you can see, I've already got some bits and bobs around here. So I'm just going to make a small wheat farm around here, around this water. So if we drop you down there. So I think I could probably get away with having a reasonable size one. Ouch, I'm walking on ender lilies, which is silly of me. Let's start planting some seeds like so. Right, and then we'll probably need some bone meal, would be a good idea. Oh, that's not hoed. My hoe's apparently run out, never mind. There we go, that'll do. Let's grab some bone meal as well. Okay, so the kind of the shortcutty thing to use bone meal is apparently working on this mod pack, so I can just spam it like so, which is nice. Another thing that would work would be a watering can. Would just increase the speed over a large area, but I'm kind of just wanting to spam a load of wheat there. Let's also grab some more of this so we can make some more sugar. Probably should plant some even more of these sugarcane plants around here somewhere. Let's just put a couple more down. There we go. Let's put one more of this. There we go. That'll be enough. So we need to head back over now. We've got some extra wheat. We want these. Here we go. So let's turn you into sugar. And then drop the wheat into here. So it's got some more growth medium. We're going to need some more bone meal. So let me go for bones. There we go. Got loads of bone meal here. I've got all of these bones from biomes of plenty as well, which should also in theory generate quite a bit of bone meal, which is pretty good. So let's turn you into growth medium just to be on the safe side. We'll generate some more because I've left sugar in there. So this is all going to process through. So I'm just trying to create enzymes before the end of the episode, and then I'll probably round it off there and go into more of these machines next time once I've had a bit more of a chance to breed up some of these bees. So let me drop a forest princess back in there. Any more combs? Any more for any more? No, I need to go hunt some more combs as well, I think. Or figure out a better way of automating this so I can just generate a ton of them while I can like leave it working off camera. How are we doing? We generate any yet? Oh yeah, I need water, don't I? Do I have an aqueous accumulator spare? I'm trying to think. There's one there, although can I just make one real quick? No, I do not have one spare, so aqueous accumulator, that's what I want. So let me make a machine frame real quick if it goes around to the basic one. There we go, that's what I want. Ugh, I just remembered it's because it's I need a tin gear first, don't I? There we go. Come on, basic. Boom, gotcha. So we've got basic machine frame, two copper gears, pneumatic servo, and that should be everything. Boom, one aqueous accumulator. Head back over to the bees, drop you down. Oh, crap's sake, that's not what I wanted. Where'd my bucket go? Oh, good, I've actually got a spare bucket right now, so let's try this again. So, bucket, and then fluid conduit. So what I can then do is just... Ah, whoops-a-daisy, that's not what I wanted to do. So that should all connect up if I wasn't being such a dummy. There we go, so that should now be pumping water in. Excellent. Grand. So we can just let that run through now. Have we made any catalyst yet? Not quite. So it's still got insufficient to actually do anything with the sugar. Is that doing something? I can't actually tell. Yeah, it's going in, so we're just waiting for enough to react with the wheat. And then I don't know how much we actually need to react with the sugar, but it looks like it's a slow process. So I'm sure we'll get there eventually. At least I've set up a nice little production line for it. So with my three incubators and my fluid con... I really do like Ender IO's fluid conduits. They are definitely very powerful compared to the fluid ducts. They're very, very versatile, put it that way. Ah, there we go. We've got some enzyme, finally. So, yeah, that's a rather successful... I wouldn't say rather successful, but mildly successful. So, I'm probably going to leave the episode here for now. As always, guys, don't forget to comment and like if you enjoyed the episode, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.